Hi, lads and ladies. How's it going? Well, I'm out in the back deck, and I'm gonna having the first taste of Cornell and Diehls Habana Daydream. I almost said Habana Nightmare. Jesus, that'd been embarrassing. Habana Nightmare. Well, maybe a nightmare. Who knows? There's no real boxes, right? This just comes in a little bag. It's not particularly exciting to look at. I got this from pipesandcigars.com. Wonderful folks, by the way. I'm smoking this out of my little no-name Italian pipe, which I think is actually Lorenzo. I think it's a beautiful pipe. It's the second pipe I ever bought. Unfortunately, like I say, there's fills on it, which I didn't realize until a lot later on. But I'm kind of proud of myself. It's never smoked right. And the fact that it has such a huge bowl and a huge bowl, and the airway was very, very small. And a couple years ago, I drilled out this part of the airway, but I could not figure out how to do this one. So if you've seen my three-part series on opening up a pipe, you'll see I figured out how to open up the stem, even a bent stem, and now this thing smokes like a dream. It only took 26 years for me to get to smoke that way. Wow. Now this stuff came very dry, pretty dry anyway, in the pretty dry in the bag. I think it came kind of the perfect consistency for smoking personally. My packing method is Frank method, and sometimes it's packed pretty tight on top, so. But it draws easy, so it takes a few times sometimes for me to get it to light. I don't know what's going on with my hair today. It's all staticky and weird. I feel like I've had a bucket of water dumped on my head. The smell of this stuff in the bag was very, almost nothing. It almost has no smell at all. Which doesn't necessarily mean anything. For younger pipe smokers out there, don't be fooled by really sweet cherry or raspberry or whatever smelling aromatics that smell wonderful, you know, because it doesn't necessarily mean they're going to taste like that or smoke well. Some folks find English tobacco to smell really nasty. I find some of it nice, but mostly I find English tobacco to be... Some of it smells good, you know, in the pouch or bag. Like, I just opened up some Maltese Falcon and smell that. It's nice, you know. Others of it smells nasty. But it has nothing to do with how it smokes, in my opinion. I mean, English tobacco doesn't smoke or taste like it smells, generally. I don't think, really. Not to me. Yeah, the physics of this pipe was that the bowl's so huge, and the hole through here was so small that you just could not get enough air to the damn thing. You suck your brains out. You'd be puffing on and try to get to work. It wouldn't work. Time's still hard to get going. This is getting a little harder to get going here. I'll hit it again here. I don't want to overpuff it. It's kind of nice. So, this isn't a review, obviously, you know, because I wouldn't know what it was really like if I smoked, you know, 10 bowls of this or something. But it has kind of a cigar flavor to it in a way. This is the pipe I smoke cigars out of, matter of fact. That's why I put it in here. I hope that's not coloring it, but there's kind of a cigar-y aspect to it. You know, if I mean, smoking cigars in the pipe isn't really that great, I found. They get kind of hot and bitey, not so good. But this is a cigar pipe tobacco, and you can tell it's got that nice pipe tobacco kind of thing going on at the same time. There's a little cigar thing going on too. It's kind of interesting. I kind of like it. It's kind of nice. First impression. Smoking cool. I'm puffing on it pretty hard. But, you know, the bowl feels almost cold. You know, it's not warm at all. You know, and I don't sense any tongue bite at all. The tobaccos I bought in this last order, this being one of them, I vetted to see if they had tongue bite, and they didn't. So I ordered, you know, all those tobaccos knowing they wouldn't bite, and that's what I wanted. All right, guys, just thought I'd share the first taste with you. Hope you're having a great day and good smokes.